Okay, to continue, further on in the story, we are told of why Rahim Khan is so angry, of why he hates everyone and everything. Okay, so as a young man, okay, there was no one who could beat him in his athletic skill. That means he was a very, very strong wrestler. Okay, he was very good in athletics, in wrestling, in kabaddi, in diving from the canal bridge. Okay, he was the strongest that could be, and no one in the village could ever beat him. He would always come first. Okay, so that was one of the things that he was talented in. Second thing was, he was in love with a girl, all right, and this girl was called Radha, all right. And third thing was that he wanted to join a circus. Now remember, this will come as a question. What are the three things that, you know, caused Rahim Khan to become an embittered soul? So the first one is the fact that he was very good in athletic skill, okay, and he had always wanted to join a circus. All right, he had always wanted to join a circus. Then he was in love with a girl called Radha, and he wanted to marry her. All right, so everything, the circus, you know, is something that was a magical place for him. It was the place where all his ambitions could come true. What are the ambitions that he had? He could travel wherever he wanted, because circuses during that time, and even today, travel from place to place and put up shows in different lands, right? Then there would be fame. He would become famous not only in the small village, but everywhere, all right? And in Radha, you know, he thought that he had found his soulmate. All right, but obviously there is a problem there. Radha is the daughter of Ram Charan, who is the village Baniya, which is a caste, okay? Now think of that. He is Rahim Khan and she is Radha. Obviously, there is bound to be trouble. He had first noticed her. How did he first meet Radha? Is told. It is a very, very romantic moment. He was once, in a wrestling match, and she had come to watch that match. And after, you know, defeating his adversary, the person who was fighting against him, after defeating him, he had stood up, you know, in a very triumphant our moment of winning, he found Radha looking at him with the light of love in her eyes. So she was very impressed by his skill. So obviously she was looking at him with love in his eyes. And at that moment, he fell in love. All right. There had been a few meetings with her. Obviously, during those times in a village, meeting the love of your life would be very difficult. But still, he had managed to meet her a few times, and they had exchanged the love that they have for each other. They had told each other about that. Okay. But obviously, his parents, for the villains here, they had killed both his ambitions. Okay. Just like any other film, it was his parents who became the villain here. They killed both ambitions. What were the two ambitions? First one was to join the circus. Second one was to marry Radha. Okay. Circus and athletic skill, it's the same. Okay. So, though those two ambitions, both of them were killed by the parents. Circus work was too lowly and immoral for respectable peasants. So even that time, even today, there is this caste-based idea that, you know, only people belonging to lower caste classes are the ones who engage in activities like the circus. Okay, anathe kaalathe ee circus kalikkunnathum dance kalikkunnathum paattu paadunnavarum okke adu class il ullavarku pattiya adhaayathu caste high caste il pattiyorkalla. And his family had been peasants or farmers for ages. Okay, avare father, grandfather, ancestors ellavarum, they had tilled the land. That means they were all farmers. Okay, so obviously Rahim Khan would also have to become a farmer. There is no chance that, you know, he could become a lowly circus entertainer. So that's why his father did not allow him to join the circus, and the circus left his town without him in it. Obviously, he was very angry then, but he still had his love for Radha. His father became the villain there also. Okay, obviously she was a Hindu, a kafir. Okay, and that idea was irreligious, it was infamous, it's not going to happen. So for some time, you know, he thought of open rebellion against his parents. He thought that he would not listen to them and do whatever he wants. But the traditions of serfdom ran in his blood. That means for tradition, you know, he had always as a peasant class, as a farmer's class, he knows that, you know, he has to listen to the word of the lords that are there. Zamindars in the pere parayunnathu kekkanam ennu ariyam. And accordingly, you know, listening to your parents also came in the blood. So he could not have enough courage to, you know, go against his parents. Hence, the circus left the village without Rahim Khan. And Radha too, our romance also came to an end because the Rahim Khan's father very, very slyly went and told Ram Charan. He said that, oh, Radha is now 15 years old. If you don't marry her, Cheetapereka Kepikim, you know, you should marry her off soon, without, you know, hinting about her affair, but he hinted about the disastrous consequences of having a 15-year-old unmarried daughter. Angane, you know, she was married to Ram Lal, who was a middle-aged, pot-bellied, vayarakachadi, oru baniya of the neighboring village, same caste anu, Radhaimite. So she was married. And with a few sad tears shed in the solitude of the night, you know, she quickly adjusted to her fate and, you know, she has half a dozen children almost after a while. So Rahim Khan also got married. He had no choice in the matter, of course. It was his parents again who selected the girl. They fixed the date and got some clothes and ornaments for the girl. And, you know, a horse in the mold keti or a brass band name which, they took him to the girl's house where the nikah was performed. All right. To the Qazi's formal questions, whether in the Kalyana Varikyan, okay, he didn't say anything. He just nodded his head. Okay. Any other course was impossible. So he could not go against the word of his father. Nobody, of course, cared to ask the girl whether she wanted to marry him or not, because it was not something that was normal. After the ceremony, Rahim Khan's father was very happy. Why? Because magande nervadileke kondu vannu alle. See how he obeyed me. You always feared that he might refuse to do what I said, but I know these youngsters. Okay, avare kalyanam vaigiyal avare, they become restless. All right, that's why, you know, we should always marry our children early. Now I know that kalyanam gadipichonda he will be fine. Now there will be no issues with him. At that very moment, standing on the threshold of his room, of the room where his wife awaited, idu ketonde nikkina Rahim Khan ayalde bedroom like kaaran nikkiyana, wife avade bedroom il wait cheyunu. At that moment, you know, he made a resolve, he made a promise to avenge himself on his parents. That means he decided to take revenge from his parents, his family, his society entirely. Ellavarum avante against aayirunnu, avante aspirations onnum nadannilla alle. So he decided to take revenge on all of them. And he held them all responsible for the frustration of his life's dreams. All his life's dream has now broken. And he held all of these people responsible for that. Okay. Obviously, he could not go and kill each and every one of them. So the bride who awaited him in that bedroom became the symbol of everything that went wrong in his life. Okay. She became the symbol of his persecution. And from that night onwards, you know, he kept beating her every single day. That was 30 years ago. And Rahim Khan thought about this as he lay on the bed today. Now that his wife has finally left after 30 years. Okay. Had he had his revenge, that is what he's thinking. Ayaka revenge kittiyo. We don't know. For 30 years, he had ill-treated his wife. Sorry, I forgot to change the slide. Okay, so this is him marrying the woman without his wish. All right. So for 30 years, you know, he had reflected as he lay there in the court. Okay, did he have his revenge? He had ill-treated his wife, his children, his bullocks, quarreled with everyone in the village, made himself to be the most hated person in the entire village. Okay, and the thought of being so universally detested, the thought that everyone dislikes him, you know, gave him a certain sense of satisfaction. No one in the village, of course, understood or tried to understand why Rahim Khan was like this. Endondana Rahim Khan ingane enna aarum orikkalum chindikkan poyilla. All right, they never thought that cheerful, reasonable man who was there in his youth, ayak endu sambhavichu ennu aarum anneshikkan poyilla. Okay, at first their attitude towards him was of astonished hostility. Pattanna kandappol endana ayak prashnam pettiyathu ennu vicharichu, and later it became indifference with fear. That means after that they didn't care, because you know, they don't want to be associated with him, and they are also afraid of him now. Of understanding and sympathy, he received none. That is what is very important, right? Someone who is who has an embittered heart, someone who is suffering, someone who is in pain, requires sympathy. He requires our understanding. But Rahim Khan never got any of that from anyone, nor from his wife, nor from his family, nor from his society. Shunned by everyone with a bitterness, ever gnawing at his heart. Aa manasil eppozhum oru bitterness undayirunnu. Rahim Khan sought consolation, okay, in the unquestioned authority that society gave him over his wife. Okay, wife inde mullil endu venalum kaanikkam, ayalodulla desham ellam avarodu kaanikkam, pakshe avar orikkalum thirichu question cheyilla. Aa oru authority upayogichu he took out all his revenge on his wife. For 30 years, his wife had submitted to his persecution with slave-like docility. That means just like a slave, you know, ellam sahikkunna oru slave ne pole thanne aa bhari ellam sahichirunnu. Okay, that is the badge of her tribe. As streegalde oru badge thanneyanu adu ennu parayunnu. Okay, lately indeed she has become so used to corporal chastisement, adayide ennum adi kondu sheelamayittu, if one day, you know, she is not beaten, she feels weird, she feels like something is wrong if she is not beaten by her husband. To Rahim Khan, beating his wife had become part of his very existence. Ayalde oru nature aayittu maariyathu. Okay, as sleep gathered around him, his last thought was whether he would be able to endure a life without, you know, doing that which had become his second nature. Adayid ini munnote ennum orale adichu sheelamayittu ini munnote aareyum adikkanillengil, will he be able to survive ennulla oru question aanu ayalude manasil vannathu. Okay, that is what he was thinking as he was falling asleep that day. It was perhaps the only moment when Rahim Khan had a feeling, not exactly of affection, adayid aa oru nimishathil mathramana bhariyode oru feeling thoniyathu, adayid snehamo affectiono onnum alla, but of loneliness without her. Adayid avalodu sneham illa ennal aval illade engane jeevikkum ennulla oru vicharam engilum vannathu aa oru nimishathil mathramana. Never before had he realized how much the woman that he hated so much had become a important part of his life. So ഇതിനു മുൻപ് ഒരിക്കലും ആ ഭാര്യ എന്തുമാത്രം അയാളുടെ ലൈഫിൽ ഇത്രയും ചേർന്നിരിക്കുന്നു എന്ന് അയാൾ വിചാരിച്ചിട്ടില്ല. He had never thought of that. So the next day, you know, when he woke up, what happened was that he woke up late because, you know, obviously it was his wife who used to wake him up early in the morning. ഭാര്യ ഇല്ലാത്തതുകൊണ്ട് നേരത്തെ എണീക്കാൻ പറ്റിയില്ല. But he was not in great hurry today. He decided that he'll take a leave and he will not go to the fields anymore. ഭാര്യയെ കാണാതിരിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടിയാണ് എന്നും ഈ പണിക്ക് പോകുന്നത്. ഇനിയിപ്പോ ആരും ഇല്ലല്ലോ, അതുകൊണ്ട് സമാധാനത്തോടെ അവിടെ ഇരിക്കാം എന്ന് വിചാരിച്ചു. ഗോട്ടിനെ ഒക്കെ മിൽക്ക് ചെയ്ത് പാലൊക്കെ എടുത്ത് കുറച്ച് ചപ്പാത്തി തലേ ദിവസം ഇരുന്നതെല്ലാം പാലിൽ മുക്കി കഴിച്ചു. Okay, then he sat down and he started smoking on his hookah. Now, you know, the hut was warm, there was light coming in, and that is when he saw that in the corner, a hut inde oru corner la korcha chukri vela cobwebs undarunu. Okay, so since he had already decided not to go to the fields, he thought that it would be good if he cleaned the house anyways. Ini bhaarya vandathonum cheyan povunnillallo, so he decided that he would clean that. Adu clean cheyan vendi poyappozhaanu he noticed that there was a nest in his thatched roof. Adayid pullu meenja roof aanu, hut aanallo. Okay, and in that thatched roof there was a nest. All right, there was a nest, and two sparrows were fluttering in and out, twittering constantly. Okay, so he saw that idana sparrows ennu parayna bird, I hope you know. So the sparrows were, you know, moving in and out of the nest, and they were obviously, as sparrows are, they are quite noisy, they are always making that sound. First impulse endana nammude Rahim Khan's swabhavam ariyalo. His first impulse was to wreck the nest with one stroke of his pole. Vadi vechu vrutiyakkan kondu poya vadi vechu otte adi vechu kodthal aa nest mulan nashipikkallo ennaayirunnu ayalde aadite oru impulse, instinct ennu parnathu. But something, you know, made him inside him made him stop. So instead he threw down the pole, he brought a stool and climbed up on it because he wanted to look inside the nest. And he wanted to look into the sparrow's home. He saw that, you know, there were two baby sparrows in it. Adayid ippo mottayinu virinja rendu flesh sparrows, avarku cheragu polum vannittilla, adu pole red flesh baby sparrows aarunnu undayirunnathu. They were hardly a day old. They lay inside while their parents were around. Our belly sparrows and they are trying to attack Rahim Khan, thinking that he has come to take the babies. Next day, you know, he, as usual, he went to work, he went to the field. Still no one talked to him in the village, even though by now most of them would know that his wife has gone, but still no one tried to talk to him. From morning till afternoon he would work in the field. Okay, and he would return home before sunset. Then he would lie on the cot, smoking his hookah and watch the antics of the sparrow family. So ayalka oru kootum illayirna samayathu, the sparrow family became something that, you know, some sort of entertainment for him. He would watch them doing whatever they would do after coming back from work. Okay. The two little ones had now grown into fine young birds. So now the two little ones have feathers. They have grown now a little bit. And now he has named these two baby sparrows. Baby sparrows in endha perana kodutha ayalde makkalde peru sonda makkalde peraya Nooru and Bundu ennu parayna rendu perana ayal kodutathu. Okay, so let me just write it down so that you don't get confused with the spelling. Nooru, N-U-R-U, and Bundu. Okay, so those were the two sparrows, baby sparrows that he got. And in those two baby sparrows, he saw his own sons whom he had lost so many years ago. Oru varsham munbu nashtapetta makkaleyanu aa sparrowsil kandathu. Okay, these four sparrows were his only friends in the entire world. So they were the only friends that he had right now. All right. That is why he became, you know, his demeanor itself started changing. Aa naalu friends ne kore naalukku shesham kittippum he started changing. Okay, and his neighbors were still frightened. He was now peaceful. Summa aarayodu mehalam vekkan povada endo oru maattam Rahim Khan lu vannu nu manasilai, but they were still scared of him. They didn't know what to do. Okay, they were astonished, they were shocked that for some time no one had seen him beating his bullocks. Nathum Chiddo ennu parayna ayalde aa kaalukalde perana adungale adikkunnathu polum kandittilla. Okay, and their bruises, adayathu sthiramayita adi kondu adungalde dehathundarna murivugalum heal cheyan thodangi. It was starting to heal. Then, you know, something happens. After a few days, one monsoon evening, you know, the sky was becoming very dark. It was about to rain. Rahim Khan was returning from the field a little earlier than usual, probably because it was going to rain. He saw when he was returning, a group of children were playing on the road. Okay. As soon as they saw him, endani naadugal ishtamillatha ee velippamare kanda pillare engenaanu avaru avadu nirangi oodu alle appo adu pole thanne iyala kanda odare thanne avaru odi. They left their shoes behind in their haste. They did not even wait to put on their shoes. In vain Rahim Khan shouted, oru kaaryam illa, avashya Rahim Khan orakke vilichu parnu, why are you running away? I am not going to beat you. Appo ayalde maattam polum aarkum notice cheyan sadhikkunnilla. They are all still afraid of him. ഞാൻ അടിക്കില്ല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞെങ്കിലും ആ കുട്ടികളെല്ലാം ഓടിപ്പോയി. മീൻ വൈൽ ഇറ്റ് ഹാഡ് സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് ഡ്രിസ്ലിംഗ്, കുറച്ച് ചാറ്റൽ മഴ തുടങ്ങി. സോ ഹി യു നോ ഹറീഡ് ഹോം ടു ടൈ അപ്പ് ദ ബുള്ളോക്സ് ബിഫോർ ദ ബിഗ് റെയിൻ കെയിം. വെൻ ഹി എന്റേർഡ് ഹിസ് ഹാർട്ട് ഹി സോ and he lit the lamp. He saw that, you know, the birds were there. So he always, after coming back, ayal kondakana chapathide korchu kashnangal ee birds inum kodukum. So he had given it to them and he called, oh Nooru, oh Bundu, he called out, but the sparrows did not come. So he wanted to know what has happened. Usually vilikina odane varuvallo. So he went and checked into the nest and saw that the four of them are four birds in a pedichu varandirikkiyana. They were all huddled up within their feathers. Okay, because at that very spot where that nest lay, a nest irna adhe spot il endaani mazha kaaranam aa roof leak cheyana and the water is coming inside the inside their nest. Okay, Rahim Khan endu cheythu oru nimisham polum chindichilla. He took a ladder and went outside in the rain and he fixed the roof. Mazhayathu ninnondu thanne aa roof fix cheythu so that the birds would be safe. Okay, as he sat on the bog cot after doing this, Rahim Khan sneezed. Vananda nane loga jaladosham pidichu, but he didn't think of anything and he went to sleep. Next morning when he awoke, he had a high fever. Then, you know, we don't know how much time passed. The villagers did not see him going to the fields for several days. Kore dosu aayittu field lote povunu onnum kaananilla and they became anxious as to what had happened to him. Otteke thamasikkunna manushyanalle. So some of them came to see what had happened. Through a crack in the door, they are afraid to call out to him. So instead, they just peered. Edakke ingane ulla cheriya space lode nokkippol, they saw that he was lying on the cot and talking to himself. Appo ottekku kedanna samsarikkunna oru manushyane aanu avaru kandathu. Oh Nooru, oh Bundu, who will feed you when I am gone? So മക്കളുടെ പേരാണല്ലേ ആ ബേബി സ്പാരോസിന് ഇട്ടേക്കുന്നത്. സോ ഹീസ് ആസ്കിങ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ആര് ഭക്ഷണം തരും എന്നൊക്കെ പറയുന്നത്. വില്ലേജേഴ്സ് ഇത് കണ്ടപ്പോഴെന്താണോ വിചാരിച്ചത്, പൂർ ഫെലോ ഹി ഹാസ് ഗോൺ മാഡ്, അയാളുടെ ഇല്ലാത്ത മകൻ മക്കളെ ആണ് വിളിക്കുന്നത് എന്ന് വിചാരിച്ചു. ഓക്കെ, വി ഷുഡ് കോൾ ഹിസ് വൈഫ് ടു ലുക്ക് ആഫ്റ്റർ ഹിം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ് ദേ ഓൾ സെൻഡ് വേർഡ് ടു ഹിസ് വൈഫ്. ഓക്കെ, ബട്ട് ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ഓൺലി നെക്സ്റ്റ് മോർണിംഗ് വെൻ ഹിസ് വൈഫ് വാസ് ഏബിൾ ടു കം. She came anxious and weak, weeping, and she had brought her two sons with them. A group of neighbors had collected in sympathy to watch because the door was locked from inside. Rahim Khan's hut's door was locked. And you know, in spite of knocking, no one opened it. കുറേ നേരം കുട്ടിയെങ്കിലും ആരും തുറന്നില്ല. അവസാനം വാതിൽ തള്ളി പൊട്ടിച്ച് കയറിയപ്പോൾ they saw, they found the large and gaunt frame of Rahim Khan lying in the brooding silence of the room. That means there was no more sound anymore except for the fluttering of the four sparrows. All right, so Rahim Khan has died. And who was his only companion in death? It was those two sparrows who were his only companion in death. All right, so here what do we see, what happens in this particular story? What happens is that throughout his life, Rahim Khan was someone who was fostering a lot of hate and anger. അയാളുടെ ഹേറ്റ് മുഴുവൻ വന്നത് ആ മനസ്സിനുണ്ടായിരുന്ന ദേഷ്യം കാരണമാണ്, വിഷമങ്ങൾ കാരണമാണ്. But no one ever tried to understand him. No one ever tried to, you know, talk to him and try and find out why he is so angry. It was only the sparrows who were not afraid of him. Even his wife was afraid of him. Okay, but the sparrows were the only one who were not afraid of him, who would come near him, and through that, you know, his compassionate nature, it came out. But it was already too late. He had already driven away. ജീവിതത്തിൽ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്ന എല്ലാവരെയും ഓടിച്ചു വിട്ടിരുന്നു ആ സമയത്തേക്ക്. He had no one, right? And that's why when he died alone in the companionship of those four sparrows. All right, so he gets transformed from a brutal person to a savior, someone who saved those sparrows from, you know, from drowning in that rain. Rahim Khan was a very good wrestler, swimming, he was good at kabaddi, and he had lots of ambitions like joining the circus and marrying Radha. But due to certain rigid conventions, ee society da kore avashyamillatha chindagalum karyangalum kaaranamaanu ayalki rand ambitionsum pursue cheyan pattada ayathu. Okay, so that is why he became brutal and unkind towards everyone else. Now obviously when he became brutal and unkind, his family members, the villagers, everyone started disliking him. His own sons ran away from them. Okay, but you know, it is only through the sparrows that Rahim Khan learns the lesson of love. Okay, he learns it from the birds. How do you take care of your children? How do you love them? ennalladellam adilodeyanu padichathu. The sparrows change his mindset and attitude to the world around and purge him of his desolation and inhuman life. They change him. Ayalde aa inhuman aayulla qualities ne ellam porathu valicherichu kalanju they bring out the good in him. Okay, Rahim Khan starts loving the birds and calls them Nuru and Bundu after his sons. Okay, he soon passes away, and when his wife and son return, they find him dead. The story is giving out a message to the world that often in life relationships weak avunnante kaaranam enda, what is the reason behind relationships becoming weak? It is usually these egoistic, you know, notions that we have in our mind. We do not want to share what is there in our heart. ullilulladu porthu parayan pattatha or avastha, nor does, you know, ayalde wife or makkalo orikkalum adu manasilakkan shramichittilla, ayalum adu thoranu parayan shramichittilla. So it is because of such egos that, you know, the relationships become weak, they break off, and you know, people are left alone. The story is a lesson in humanity, which tells us that, you know, in even though there might be different adversities, different issues that we might face in life, we should never let go of what is good in us, because the good or humanity in the Varanadana, that is the essence of life. If you don't have humanity, if you don't have goodness, you will end up dead alone like Rahim Khan. If his wife and children had been there, it was just a fever. They would have, you know, helped him to become better. But he had to die alone on that bed with just four sparrows who could do nothing to help him because of his egoistical nature, because he was not willing to let people in. So it is a lesson for us to know that, you know, first thing that we learn from the story is that we should let go of such egoistical feelings that we have in our hearts. We should let go of the unwanted hurt, anger, bitter feelings that we have in our heart. We should not, you know, make someone else the symbol of our sufferings. Like Rahim Khan made his wife and children the symbol of his sufferings, even though it could have been solved very, very easily. Right? That should not happen. Similarly, it tells us about how we should also reach out to people. Just because someone seems unapproachable, just because someone seems to be cruel and rude, you should not leave it at that. No one is born cruel and rude. Okay, they become like that due to their circumstances. So maybe a little bit of understanding, a little bit of love can help change people. That's the lesson that we learn here. Okay, and that is the end of the story. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.